we have seen how we can use the singular value decomposition of a matrix to describe the corresponding mapping geometrically. For large matrices, it's obviously difficult to draw something, so let's do it for a relatively small example in this video. So we go from R3 to R2, T of x equals A times x, and we take this 2x3 matrix A. We take this one because we already know its singular value decomposition. We did that in a previous video, as was given like this. So there we have our U, sigma, and V transpose. Now we start in R3, so we start with a unit sphere. So we start as a domain with x1 squared plus x2 squared plus x3 squared equals 1. So what happens geometrically here? Of course, we go from right to left as usual. So we start with this matrix Vt. What's the matrix Vt doing with our unit sphere? Well, it's rotating the unit sphere twice around origin. But if you rotate a unit sphere, nothing happens. So Vt leaves the unit sphere as it is. Then, next, our matrix sigma is coming. So what is the matrix sigma doing with our unit sphere? Now we see that we will map to an ellipse with a semi-major axis square root of 2 and 1. And due to those zeros over here, we will map to the interior of the ellipse. So that's what sigma is doing. So sigma is actually doing most of the action. So we were at our unit sphere, and due to our sigma, we now get the ellipse and all of its interior. And finally, okay, this one is a bit silly. What's the matrix U doing in this case? Well, absolutely nothing, of course. It's the identity matrix. But also, if you had something else, it would just be rotating your ellipse. So it wouldn't be doing much anyway. So your U leaves your ellipse as it is. So that's how you can read a singular value decomposition geometrically. Read from right to left. The matrices on the borders are not doing much. And most of the action is, as always, done by the sigma matrix in the middle.